In this video, we're going to talk about type parameters versus instance parameters in Revit with Dynamo. That sounds interesting. Check out the rest of this video. All right, so here we are in the Revit sample model. I'm in Revit 22, and a topic that comes up pretty often is regarding type parameters versus instance parameters. It's actually one of the first questions I had myself when I started using Dynamo back in 2014. I went on the Dynamo forums and asked how to interact with type parameters, and great people on the forums helped me out. So I thought I'd make for a cool video. So once again, we're in the sample model. I'll just pop open Dynamo and we'll go ahead and collect, in this case, we'll collect walls. So I'll do categories, walls. We'll do all elements of category to collect all the walls in our model. Cool. So we're good to go there. If we were to, and I'll just get the first wall in this case, just to work with the first item of that list. So if we were to want to interrogate this element for the parameters available to us, if we go to Revit, elements, element, we have an option in here to get all the parameters available on that element. So we'll see element parameters. These are all instance parameters. So when you collect things in Revit in this way, in Dynamo, you get the individual placed instances in the model, and we can actually click on this element ID to kind of highlight them. So this element is this one over in the corner. We can do select by element ID. And we'll see that that's the wall that I'm working with. So that's just kind of how that connection starts to happen. All right, so we'll make Dynamo bigger again. We'll see that we have all the instance parameters available to us. If I want to get at a type parameter, so if I were to go edit type, these are all type parameters for that wall type. How would I get to those? That's one of the questions new users have very often. So if we come in here, we'll see that we have a few different parameters in here, and let's assign a type mark real quick of A1. And another one has A1, so let's do ZZ just to make it different. And we'll see that we have type mark. If I were to want to get that parameter value in Dynamo, we can do get parameter value by name. I'll connect my wall. I'll type in type mark. And we'll see that it returns a blank. So Dynamo is pretty good at returning blank values. If it can't find the parameter, that's fine. The node didn't turn yellow, which is okay, but that's not super helpful because I gave it a parameter that doesn't work at this time. So in order to get type parameters, we have to mimic this interaction, this edit type button that we click in the UI. And the way that we imitate that interaction is we actually have to get the element type of the given element. And that node is right here, and it doesn't have an icon in this version of Dynamo. So it's element.elementType. If we connect the element instance to the element type node, we'll now see that we're retrieving a type from the element instance. And now you'll see that our element.parameters node has all the different parameters available in that type dialog. And we will see the type mark in here as well. If I were to change the element type and plug this into my get parameter value, we will see that we have a type mark here of ZZ. So that did what it's supposed to. We're mimicking that edit type interaction. This is a very useful way to do this. This question comes up pretty often for me personally, because in Rhythm, so let's go ahead and navigate to Rhythm here. Rhythm's a custom package for Dynamo that I build. Under Revit, elements, we do have a get parameter value by name type or instance. So this is actually one of my most used nodes, I think, from my Dynamo package. And I actually created this node to be able to explore these kind of interactions. So when I was working with element instances, and I know I want to see what kind of values are available, you can just feed in an element instance. And now we'll reuse this code block. It will automatically retrieve whatever different parameter value we have. So in this case, that is a type parameter. Let's go ahead and do something that's instance like comments, and we'll see that it will start to try to retrieve that. So let's add a comments value of this is a comment. And now we'll see that that is retrieving instance parameters or type parameters. This node will run slower, so that is a big consideration to keep in mind because it initially checks for instance parameters. It will iterate through and see if it exists. If it doesn't, it moves on to type and tries those. If it doesn't exist at all, so like if you type in something super random as a parameter value, it will return a blank like Dynamo does. This node's for exploration of your elements to be able to see what parameter values are. I wouldn't use this all the time. If you know that it is a type parameter that you want to get at, you need to convert it to an element type and extract it in that manner. So this one's for exploratory interactions, and this would be stable for you to use moving forward. So that's another thing to keep in mind. If you know what kind of parameter you're getting, use the correct one for it because this has a few extra steps built into it. Rhythm is open source on GitHub, so you can kind of see how I did that if you'd like. And it goes through all the different parameters initially at first. So yeah, for setting instance parameters, it's the same thing. You have to set it on the element itself. If you're setting a type parameter, you set it on the type itself. So I encourage you to try that out as well. But yeah, there we have it. That's a pretty quick one. It's instance parameters versus type parameters. If you're a new Dynamo user, that's probably something you'll run into eventually. I know I did, and I hope that helps out. And thanks for checking out this video.